Hello everyone, this is a free online tutorial for the New City Math section. This is problem number 18, practice test 6, section 3, no calculator. Okay, this is a grid in question. And in the figure above, BD is parallel to AE. What is the length of CE? So, what does this mean? BD is parallel to AE. If BD is parallel to AE, it means that angle CBD is a right triangle, is a right angle, 90 degrees, okay, angle CBD. So if this is a 90 degree angle, and since these two triangles share the same angle C, it's already enough to know that these two triangles CBD and CAE are similar, okay, because if they have at least two of their interior angles the same measure, that means they are similar. Okay, now if they are similar, it means that there's a constant of proportion involved. And what do I mean by that? That means that when you multiply 6 by a constant, you will get 18. Okay, and if you multiply 8 CB by a constant, you will get CA, the measure of CA. And the same thing for the CD. If you multiply CD by a constant, you will get CE. Okay, so the same constant will be applied for all sides when you're comparing the small angle and the bigger parent, the small triangle and the bigger parent triangle. Okay, since they're similar, the constant of proportionality is handy and very useful here. Okay. So the first thing I would do, I would find the value of CD. And why do I need that? Because if we find the value of CD and then we find the constant using the 6 and 18, we can find using the known constant what CE equals, because if we find CD and the constant, we can find CE. Okay? So let's find CD. How do you find CD? Since this is a right triangle with right angle CBD, you can use the Pythagorean theorem, right? Because CB squared plus BD squared is equal to CD squared. So that means CD, if you take the square root, CD will equal CB squared plus BD squared inside a square root, right? So that's going to be 8 squared plus 6 squared inside the square root is going to give you 100, because 100 inside the square root, and that's going to give you 10, right? Because 8 squared is 64, 6 squared is 36. And you should know that. You should not have to use a calculator. You're not going to be allowed to use the calculator in this problem. You should know that 8 squared is 64 and 6 squared is 36. And 64 plus 36, you should memorize that. It's going to be 100, right? So 100 square rooted is going to be 10. So now you found your CD. Now we need to find the constant of proportion that I talked about, because 6 times a constant is equal to 18. So this constant does something to 6 to make it 18, and the same constant would do something to 8 to make it CA, and the same constant doing something to 10, CD, will make it CE. So let's find this constant. 6 times C is equal to 18. So dividing both sides by 6 will give you 3, right? 18 by 6 is 3. Bingo, you just found your constant. So 10 times the same constant C will give you CE, right? So now 10 times C is equal to CE, and you know that the constant is 3, so 10 times 3 is 30. Bingo, CE is equal to 30.